Well, Shaun the Sheep came from one of the Wallace and Gromit films. In fact, the third Wallace and Gromit film, A Close Shave.
Oh, come over here, lad. No need to be sheepish.
Bob Baker and myself had written The Wrong Trousers, and we were thinking of a sequel, which was all about sheep rustling and wool.
Oh, dear.
And we came up with this little character called Shaun.
This time, they've set up their own window-cleaning business, and they're visited by an escaped sheep.
He's like this innocent little victim that comes and seeks refuge in Wallace and Gromit's house.
What's all this?
At first, they don't know what's going on. They think, is there a pest around the house?
Mice, do you think?
They pick him up, and Wallace, in the usual puntastic way, calls him Shaun the Sheep.
Oh, looks okay to me. We'll call him Shaun, eh?
Shaun has grown to be a big, memorable, unforgettable, lovable character.
There was an instance in the 90s when Baby Spice was photographed wearing a Shaun backpack. We knew instantly, you know, Shaun was a big hit.
There was a great public outpouring of love for Shaun from A Close Shave.
Get off me, cheese!
And that's when we thought, actually, is there a world in which these could inhabit? Can we wrap stories around them?
I had this kind of idea brewing that Shaun would make a good TV series.
We spent quite a lot of time playing around with how to bring him back without Wallace and Gromit.
The same time next week!
It was really, you know, Richard Starzac picked it up and ran with it and really injected a lot of his humour into it.
To me, Shaun is like a 10 to 12-year-old boy. He pushes against the boundaries that are set for him. He's the kind of character that if there's a button that says do not press, he will eventually press it.
Richard also introduced the family dynamics on the farm. Bitzer and the farmer, and Shaun being this little power of excitement.
Even in the early days in Shaun the series, it wasn't long before I was thinking he could be a movie star. We wanted to have a terrific story arc for Shaun. I thought the only way of doing that is to take him out of his comfort zone, take him away from the farm, take the flock away from the farm, and put them somewhere where they're going to find life really difficult.
So Shaun went to the big city in his first film. Sheep in the City, yes, great.
Shaun 1 was a great success. It connected with people around the world.
How do we follow a film like that?
Shaun and spaceships and aliens.
Our brains just exploded so we could have crop circles, secret sort of underground bases and all sorts.
That opens up all these possibilities everywhere.
It's just been a great adventure. For Shaun, it's the biggest adventure he's ever been on. He goes out of the earth, into space. He explores underground bases and secret hideouts, and it's just incredible in terms of where he's come from. It's definitely his biggest adventure.
And yeah, I think about it like sometimes like from Close Shave, and now like we're in outer space, sort of like it's just madness. It's great.
Where do you go after you've been into space?
If you've got a character like Shaun, you want him to stay as he is because he's fun, because he's funny, he's creative, he's imaginative, he's mischievous, he's all these things. That's who we want him to be. But you also want him to develop.
What he's going to do in the next film, I've got no idea. But the essence of his character, that mischievousness and that inquiring mind and that desire to have fun, is certainly going to be there.